Okay, we have so far analyzed induction machines with unbalanced supplies and also single phase induction motors. Single phase induction motor we know is a particular case of an unbalanced or asymmetry, right. Now, we can extend the same theory to any type of asymmetry in the stator. Okay. That means, we look at a generalized model, right. Now, we were so far constrained that the two windings were at 90 degrees, right, or three windings were at 120 degrees. So, why not we take a general asymmetry where the windings may not be same, okay, they will have different number of turns, and number two is they may not be dispossessed by 2 pi by n. Right. So, they are not at 120 degrees or 90 degrees as the number of phases. Now, that is one important feature. So, if we can have a theory which can tackle any type of asymmetry, then what will happen is any symmetrical machine will become then a particular case of that asymmetrical model. Is it okay? So, and then we will try to see whether whatever we have studied under a symmetrical situation, we can get at the same thing. Now, for unbalanced situations, till now you are mostly confined to the so called symmetrical component concepts. But for symmetrical components, invariably you require the machine to be symmetrical, right. Your Z1, Z2, Z0 have to be specific, and they were specific to a symmetrical machine. Z1, Z2, Z0 were not for asymmetrical machine. And we somehow correlated what is the correlation between the symmetrical components and the associated fields. We said that the forward field is associated with positive sequence and the backward field is associated with negative sequence, right. And now, if we can look at it a different way, that whenever you have a winding which is excited by a sinusoidal current, we know it gives rise to forward and backward fields, is not it? Now, that field will interact with other windings in the machine, both in the stator and rotor. And it is this reaction which will be cumulatively can be studied, right. Now, this is called a generalized rotating field theory. Generalized because it takes care of any general machine and it is based on the concept of counter rotating fields, because any winding will give rise to in the air gap forward and backward fields, right. So, and that will have a correlation with symmetrical components, but let us see when they are correlated, when they are not correlated, and what is the similarities and differences. Okay. Now, this is what we will try to discuss today. Okay. Now, a performance of an induction motor, you have one, there are two aspects of the things. Okay. One is you define it by two sets of equation. One you call it as internal equations, that is internal to the machine, you have an internal equation, and other is external equations, that means how you connect externally. For a machine, what do you connect externally? Electrically, you connect a voltage sources, you connect voltage sources externally, and you can connect them also in any asymmetrical fashion. Okay. Just to give an example, simplest way of asymmetry may be, you normally connect this is what you connect, in a way you might make a star connection So, this is one way of connecting, right. Now, you can make a you can make an asymmetry. Okay. Now, for some reason you connect them this, all right, but you know, supposing you connect like this, so it automatically becomes asymmetrical. You reverse one of the phases by mistake or whatever it is, it may happen, okay, right. So, even in a 3-phase supply, there could be, you can create asymmetries either in star or delta, okay. This is symmetrical, this is asymmetrical, is it okay? But then how do you analyze such machines, right? Then your external equations will become different, because you have only voltage sources V A, V B, V C, is not it? How this V A, V B, V C get connected to the winding, the voltage sources, okay? So, the sources and the machine, so this connection is external to the machine. From the terminal to this, you have external equations, but when you go into the machine, there is internal equations, okay. So, this is one thing we generally do this, okay. And what are the internal equations? That is internal to the machine, they are particular to the, peculiar to the machine, and you express the phase voltages in terms of phase currents and the parameters, okay. So, internal to the machine, your phase voltages and phase currents, and can you make some type of parameter? That means, can I write in some form, you know, let us say, if you say V A, V B, V C, I can write a matrix or impedances I A, I B, I C. So, can I define a Z matrix, right? You know, each, so that is internal behavior. So, you can always say, I can always say Z A A, Z A B, Z A C, because we are all looking at sinusoidal steady state. So, we call impedance, not transients or dynamic, okay. So, this will be Z B A, Z B B, Z B C, and Z C A, Z C B, Z C C. So, supposing if it is a 3-phase machine, it will be this, but if it is M phase machine, you can have similarly M into M matrix, M current and M voltages, right. So, let us say, can we evolve into this, right. Now, so therefore, these are called the, what Z inside, what should it be, these are called also rotating field parameters, okay. Now, these are based on generalization of counter rotating field theory. And now, another thing is, the, we should include space harmonics. What is space harmonics? What is space harmonics? We have been always talking about harmonics, right. I always say, here we talk two things, one is space harmonics and time harmonics. What is space harmonics? Due to asymmetry. Due to? Asymmetry. No, it can happen in symmetry also. Non-uniform air gap. No, non-uniform air gap may create, but what is space harmonic? See, harmonics in MMF wave, right. See, you have an MMF, supposing you have a conductor, a coil which is placed like this, A dash, okay. You know that if you have just a one conductor, the MMF waveform may be squarish like this, a rectangular, okay. Because flux lines will go up like this, isn't it? because this will be the flux line, is not it? If you pass a current, the flux will go round. So, if you place inside a slot a coil, one coil, so in effect it will not be a sinusoid, it will be a rectangular one. Okay. And now, if you make more coils, supposing I have, instead of one, I have, let us say, three coils, let you know, something like this, then you know that it will give rise to some type of a stepped wave. Okay, so it may go like this. Okay, right? So it will be a stepped wave if you have a more coils. So one coil it is like a superposing rectangles, but displaced by the slot angle, right? So you have one rectangle, maybe another rectangle, you know, like this. So add it, you will have a cumulative stepped wave. Is it clear? Now, but in all our analysis, what we do, we always say, okay, I mean, maybe like that, but I only take the fundamental. This is the fundamental F1. We take fundamental only, because we do not take the harmonics, right? But any non-sinusoidal periodic wave will automatically have harmonics, right? So it will have third harmonic, fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic, because if it is asymmetry is there, it may even give it rise to even harmonics. So this may have a third harmonic, so this may be F3, right? And maybe it can even have fifth harmonic. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this may be F5. So in effect, your MMF will have F1 plus F3 plus F5, etcetera. Okay, and it can, in general, even you can have the MMF will be sigma Fn n equal to 1 to infinity, is not it? So you can say, let us say F1 cos theta plus F3 cos 3 theta, etcetera, or maybe even it can have F2 cos 2 theta also. So it can be a sigma Fn cos n theta n equal to 1 to infinity. Is it right? So I am just writing the standard Fourier series. So these are all, apart from fundamental, you call these as space harmonics. Is it clear? Any doubt? Okay. All of you are clear now. What do you mean by space harmonic? So any non-sinusoidal wave, MMF wave produced, okay, it will give rise to this. Right. Now, what will be its impact? What will happen in the so-called rotating field concept now? I apply, you know, for the machine, agreed, you know, that there are, you have a a machine and which will have all the harmonics, right? So, it will have the fundamental, okay, and it will have the third harmonic, MMF wave, okay, etcetera. But you pass a current I, in the windings and you call it as I equal to I max cos omega t, sinusoidal volt current you are passing. Now, then we told that it will give rise to forward and backward fields, right. So, this let us F 1 will lead to F 1 forward plus F 1 backward, is not it? Is right, it will give rise to with half the amplitude, okay, it will one moving forward, okay, and another moving backward, sorry, with half the amplitude, agreed. So, that is what we said, if it is only the fundamental is assumed, but what about third harmonic, because this third harmonic, this will also give rise to third harmonic forward plus third harmonic backward, is not it? Okay. Now, what is the difference between the fundamental and third harmonic? What speed and what pole number? So, if this has pole number p, this will be 3 p, okay. And what will be the speed of the field? So, this corresponds to n s, this corresponds to n s by 3. So, what will be the frequency of induced voltages by these fields? Will be f s by 3. What will be this speed, you know, after all you told it will running at, say if fundamental is 3000 rpm, this will be 1000 rpm, is not it? And the fundamental is 2 pole, this will be 6 pole, what will be the frequency of induced voltage by these fields in the same winding? After all, these fields will also induce, there is induced voltage in the wind. What is the frequency?
It is forward n plus 1 minus s by n.
So, for n s it will be 3, this will be s times of f s, and for
there is no s here, there is no s slip at all, do not bother about slip. See, it is winding is sitting pretty stationary. It is pass, you are passing current, okay, and it gives rise to a field in the air gap, okay, and those fields, these air gap fields will induce voltages in those in the winding, including the one which is carrying the current. It will be F only. So, frequency, important thing is frequency of induced voltages by all space harmonics will be same, and that is same as F, the fundamental frequency in which you are exciting the winding, okay. But if you want to make things complicated, if the current going into the winding has time harmonics, so the current is not sinusoidal. Nowadays with power electronics you make everything very messy anyway, right. So, current carried will also have instead of 50 hertz, 100 hertz, 150 hertz or whatever it is, okay. So, then what will happen? It will also induce those additional frequencies, because you will have additional fields, even with sinusoidal current, even with sinusoidal MMF, you will have 3F, 5F and so on. Okay? So, that is time harmonics, right? Any doubt on this or any confusion? Have you understood? There are two ways. One is the winding will give rise to a non-sinusoidal MMF distribution in the air gap, which give rise to additional fields other than the fundamental field. Another thing is you do not pass 50 hertz or the fundamental frequency current into the windings, but you can also give a non-sinusoidal current fed into the windings, which will add to additional currents and additional fields. Okay. So, you will have NF induced because of nth time harmonic. Okay. Now this, any doubts? Time harmonic will produce space harmonic. Time harmonic will not produce space harmonic. Time harmonic will produce time harmonic, okay? But it will give to additional fields, right? So the thing is, you can say, for example, say if you only put F, it will give rise to different fields. That is, N, let's say 3N. 5N, okay, which will be having P, N by 3, N by 5, this will be 3P, 5P, etcetera, okay. Now, if this, in addition, if you have, for example, let us say 3F, okay, so 3F will results in what? Synchronous speed will become 3N, okay, and then this will be N, 3N by 5, right, and then again the poles will be same, okay, P, 3P, 5P, etcetera, and this will all give rise to 3F now, whereas this will give rise to F. Right. So, but then your fields are different. Okay. Now, we will go back external equations. These are peculiar to the connection and express relation between the phase voltage and currents, supply voltage and impedances. Okay. This is external to the thing. Suppose you connect a capacitor, it becomes external equation. Okay. Therefore, sometimes they call it as inspection equations, and by, so you write the external equation by just say simply writing Kirchhoff's laws, okay. External is KCL you write, there is no problem, okay. Now, we have seen it, you know, I think it is just a repeat. So, a single phase induction motor, main and axial windings, supposing they are not displaced by 90 or 120 degrees. See, it happens. Supposing this is again a peculiar case where it is not 90 degrees or 120 degrees. Okay. Then also you are concerned with space harmonics, okay, because electrical asymmetries are there. Because electrical asymmetry, there will be space harmonics. Okay. Now, this generalized rotating field theory, what we are now going to discuss, is extension of the counter rotating field theory, which includes space harmonics. So, what we are trying to say is, there will be forward fields, there will be backward fields by fundamental and also by harmonics. Okay? So, if you have single winding excited by AC, so you will have a series of chain of fields in the air gap. So, you can imagine it is like several magnets rotating after several pole strengths, several fields, several speeds. Okay? So, it is a, it is not such a disciplined situation, pretty indisciplined, you know, just like your hostel mess or something. Okay? So, so many people, you know, like that. Okay, so now involves solving, so we have to think of a internal and external equations. Okay, so let us see how we go about it, right. Now, on single phase machine we have done, I do not want to repeat it further. We have already seen if it is only one winding is there, then you take the other two windings carry you know in a inspection equation. In that case will be, you have only one winding carrying a voltage V across A phase and B phase do not carry the current. So, we have already seen that this results in the three currents I naught equal to I 1 equal to I 2 equal to V over Z naught plus Z1 plus Z2, okay. And we have also seen that the current in each phase will be 3V over Z0 plus Z1 plus Z2, that we have done, okay. We have done using the symmetrical component concept, okay. So, impedance we are expressing the impedance in terms of the sequence impedances, saying Z0 plus Z1 plus Z2 by 3 is for a single machine. So, if you have one winding, we write it in terms of three impedances, okay. You apply a voltage V, it draws a current I decided by Z1, Z2, Z0 all by 3. This you know, we have done this, okay. Now, if you have a two phase model, okay, where only one phase is excited, then we say IB equal to 0. And V equal to VA, okay. Then again we did the same thing, let us say two phase V minus VA dash and IB dash is 0, and we got the expression I1 dash equal to I2 dash equal to V over Z1 dash by Z2 dash, this we have done this. And IA dash, that is the current in the A phase, will be equal to I1 dash plus I2 dash, which is 2 V over Z1 dash plus Z2 dash, that we have done, okay. So, the impedance here will be Z1 dash plus Z2 dash by 2, and so if this is the VA and this is the IA, or dash is only to indicate that they are a two phase system, then we have done this Z1 dash by 2 or Z2 dash by 2, and we discovered Z1 Z2 are different in a three phase mode and a two phase mode, okay. And we proved that both are effectively the same impedance. Right. Now, the question is, what will happen with the space harmonic being present? Okay. Now, in many of the machines, the third harmonic is predominant. Now, the third zero sequence component will have predominant third harmonic. If it is a three phase machine, zero sequence of third harmonic, but two phase machine, if you have two phase symmetrical components, now that third harmonic, see if the third harmonic is there, it has to get into one of these impedances Z1 or Z2, okay. So, this third harmonic, which can be accounted for in a three phase model, cannot be accounted in a two phase model, and so third harmonic has to somehow get into the Z1 or, because there is no Z0 here, okay. Now, how this has to be accommodated, that is what we will see today, right. If the zero sequence is associated with third harmonic air gap fields, if it is a three phase model, it is okay, but if you have a two phase model, what happened to that? Okay, now what we need to understand is, in the generalized rotating field theory, analysis of pure single phase motor by counter rotating field theory, then we look at the general polyphase machine and we look at the symmetrical three phase machine, then we look at the symmetrical two phase machine, and we look at a general case. These are the things we will now look at. First, let us take only one winding excited, write the equations, add other windings, write the general equations, then particular cases we will see and see where we are leading to, okay. So, we are getting into a tunnel, okay. and then we'll see how to come out of the tunnel. Okay. Now we are saying that MMF produced by a single phase winding supplied with sinusoidal current, no time harmonics, is stationary in space. This is a statement, and this you know, and pulsating at a frequency, at sub frequency, supply frequency. This is what you know. So, it is a magnet which is goes on pulsating, but axis is not changing. It is a standing wave, goes on changing, sometimes become north pole, sometimes south pole. It has a different magnitude in between. Okay, sometimes zero poles, I mean zero magnetism. Okay, so you know it is a pulsating field. Now, we have said this MMF wave can be resolved into two rotating wave. Therefore, we have infinite series of harmonics now, right? That is what we have mentioned already. We have infinite series of harmonics rotating, but axis is same of one winding axis, right? Is it clear? So, we have several fields. Now, if the single phase winding is symmetrical, okay, then only odd harmonics are present. But means, you know, if the phase belt is 180 degrees phase belt, symmetrical. But if you make it asymmetrical, you know, then even the harmonics may be present. Okay. Supposing, you know, if you have a nice MMF wave like this, 0, pi, 2 pi, it is symmetrical. But supposing you do not make it 180 degrees, you make it 160 degrees for some reason. So, if supposing your waveform is if your waveform is like this. 0, it may not be pi, pi is here and this is 2 pi. Suppose I put the coil here like short carding, I am just giving one example. Then this F 1 and this is F 2, which is not same, here F 1 equal to F 2, symmetrical. Here there will be, what you compare these two waveform, what harmonics will be present, what harmonics will not be present. Here, what will happen in this stop? No even harmonics. Here, there will be, it will have both odd and even. Here, only odd. So, 1, 3, 5 will be there, because of symmetry. Okay. So, a general practice, we can consider both odd and even harmonic fields. Let us consider this. Okay. Now, we also know the stationary pulsating field is resolved into two equal opposite fields having magnitude half of the original field. I mean, this is MMF resolution, not the field resolution, not the flux. We have explained it coincidentally. Okay. So, same principle can be applied to each of the harmonics of the MMF wave. Okay. So, each harmonic component, each harmonic means there is one forward field, one backward field of stator MMF. What will it do? It gives rise to induction motor reaction. There is one forward field. In fact, you are happy in three phase symmetrical machine because there is only one field to deal with in the air gap. Then we make single phase, we had one more field which was going the opposite direction, okay, backward field. Now, I am introducing more fields, okay, only with one winding only. So, but they will, each of the field will react with the rotor. Rotor we are taking squirrel cage only. Rotor we are, fortunately we are not done anything with the rotor. Okay. Rotor is a squirrel cage short circuited rotor, each of the field will induce currents in that, no, they are impartial. So, each of the air gap stator MMF will induce a current into the rotor, they will react, it will produce its own flux, MMF excitation and its own forward flux. Okay. Now, at standstill, both exert equal and opposite reactions. If the rotor is held at standstill, reaction is expected to be same in the rotor conductors, isn't it? If the forward field passes at any instant in any bar some x ampere of current, the backward field is also producing the same bar x ampere of current, right? At that instant, right? Therefore, but on the rotor, and thus rotor cannot distinguish between forward and backward field at stationary, when it is stationary. Okay, when stationary, relative speed is same. Okay, but when it is running condition, reaction is different. Forward field will induce a different current and backward field will induce a different current, because relative motion of the rotor conductor with respect to the respective fields is different, right? So they will all be, so forward backward reaction will be different. So each of the flux waves, okay, therefore there will be one forward flux resultant flux wave, one backward flux resultant flux wave. Each of them will induce a voltage in the same stator winding. Okay, same stator winding. So each of the field will induce a voltage. Okay. After all, this stator winding is sitting pretty in the stator slots, but it will go on be, you know, touching, you know, several fields, which are also, this field is also will have an impact of the rotor currents. Okay. Is it okay? Therefore, this will be both forward and backward field will be there, right? Now, what will be the voltage that will be in the winding? Okay. So, if this is the winding in which you want to know, and you are applying a voltage V, isn't it? Applying a voltage V and passing a current I. What will be the voltage? There will be voltage due to the leakage reactance drop, isn't it, in the winding. There will be voltage due to the fundamental forward field. There will be voltage due to the fundamental backward field induced in the same winding, okay, is equal to 4.4 Fn phi, right. There will be voltage due to second harmonic forward field and second harmonic backward field, right. So, you can have any voltages, all will be there induced in the same winding. Is it clear? Well, one due to its own winding resistance leakage reactance, and then this will all be inducing the voltage all at fundamental frequency, right. Therefore, we can write that voltage induced will be VL, that is due to leakage reactance, voltage induced in the winding due to its own resistance and leakage reactance. Okay, then it will be a voltage due to all forward fields n equal to 1 to infinity, and voltage due to all backward fields n equal to 1 to infinity. Okay. Are you clear with this step? Okay. Now, we will consider the voltage induced due to forward field by the current I can be represented by I into Zfn. That means Vfn will be I into Zfn, and Vbn will be I into Zbn. Okay. So, this Zfn is the net forward impedance, okay, and this is Zbn is the net backward impedance, which includes the rotor reactions, which includes the rotor resistance, leakage reactance, everything, you know, Zf, Zb. Okay. If you neglect the harmonics, this will be only Zf1 and Zb1. Okay. So, we take all harmonics into account. So, there is a voltage which will have, each of the fields will give rise to this. Okay. So, we can now say a single winding excited by current with applied voltage V, a phase current I will have a ZL will be resistance and coil end reactions. So, it will not include the leakage reactance due to harmonic fields that may go into Z its own air gap fields. ZFN is called the impedance corresponding to nth harmonic forward field, ZBN impedance corresponding to nth harmonic backward field. Okay. ZFN, ZBN. I want you to understand each step which I am taking, you know, do not skip. If you do not understand, please stop me. Right?
Sir,
yes.
We are considering V as a stator voltage.
Applied voltage.
Applied voltage.
Yes.
Then, sir, it will, rotor current will have some effect on that also, because rotor current will induce some voltage.
Yeah, yeah. No, that is why rotor current will induce rotor currents. What will it do? If a current is induced in the rotor, it will produce an MMF in the rotor surface, isn't it? And the flux, forward flux will be changed because rotor currents. Forward flux, how is the voltage induced? Voltage is induced not due to MMF, due to the flux. Which flux? What is the net air gap flux? So, already rotor current will have an impact on the voltage induced, because that will have an impact on the net air gap flux. When there is a rotor current there, rotor surface gets magnetized differently in proportional to the rotor current. Okay. So, what is the net flux? See, air gap flux is due to the MMF between the stator and rotor surface, right. So, rotor reaction is inbuilt in these impedances, okay. It is already there. In fact, you know, if you want to know what is the impedance. In fact, it is given in the literature. So, in fact, even the ZFN will include some leakage path as well as it will have some impedance, it will also have some RC, the core loss component, this XMN by 2. So, this will be RR by SN and this will be X RN or something like that. Okay. So, it is already there. Right? So, this current which will be going here will have an impact on this. So, this is your Z, because this is your VFN across the nth harmonic. Same with VBN. Right. So, single phase induction mode, the equivalent circuit will contain all harmonic impedances in series with fundamental impedance. Okay. Now, the effect of stray losses, you know, is neglected to avoid complexity, because there are also stray losses. Each of the field will also induce, you know, create some eddy currents in the cores. So, that will also create, and each of the fields will also create some leakage fluxes, etcetera. Okay. So, that is how the induction machine, though it is simple to make, is complicated and it creates all these problems, okay, in analysis. Yeah. Now, we will represent the equivalent circuit of a single winding machine like this. This is V and this is I. This is the ZL leakage impedance. This is typically RS plus JXL S. So, ZF1, ZB1 and up to ZFN, ZBN, is not it? So, it will each of this. So, this will be VF1, VF, VB1, VFN, VBN. These are the voltages induced in the same winding. Okay. Right. Now, this is for one winding. Okay. Now, you can have a general machine with three windings, say. This is your reference winding. A winding you take as reference. Now, this B winding we may be at some angle theta b with reference to A, and the C will have another angle theta c with reference to A, is not it? Need not be 120 degrees. I am making a general case of this, and this may have, let us say, k b times the A winding, and this may have k c times the A winding, right. Number of terms may be, in a symmetrical machine theta b equal to theta c, there will be 240 and 120 degrees respectively, and k b k c will be 1, right, that is symmetric. Okay. Now, if we take a 3 phase machine and rotor is symmetrical, now if A phase as a reference, we will take a general equation, just write the general equation, stop it. Okay. Now, we are say turns, ratio of turns on BC is KB KC, but for nth harmonic it may not be same because there is a winding factor. I hope all of you know winding factor, is not it? Winding factor will depend upon the harmonics, right. So, there will be KBN, KCN, okay, due to the winding factors. So, in general case, what we can write it is VA, VB, VC will be like this, impedances. Okay. We can write it in this fashion in terms of IA, IB, IC. Okay, now what are these impedances? ZA is what? ZAA we have written already. That is, what is ZAA? Is V by IA when IB, IC is 0. Okay, ZAA, right. Then that is okay, ZAL, ZFN, ZBN, that is what we have written. Okay. Now, what will be the volt, what is ZAB? ZAB is the voltage induced the B winding due to A phase current, is not it? It is ZAB represents the voltage induced in the B winding due to A phase current. Okay. Then what will happen? Since the B winding is having KB times the A winding, right, number of turns, so KB will be there, then the voltage induced will be, of course, that will also have the nth harmonic KBN into ZF, whatever, if it was inducing a voltage ZFN in the A winding, it will induce a voltage KB, KBN times ZFN into, and when will it induce? It will induce after theta B, because it is located theta B angle with reference to A winding. Okay. So, forward field, it will be e to the power of minus j n theta B, okay. And backward field will be e to the power of plus j n theta B. Okay. See, forward backward field, it will induce, as we have discussed in 2 phase machines. So, there is a voltage induced in the B winding due to A phase currents. If it was producing a voltage V in the A winding, it will produce a KB times V in the B winding, but it will not induce in the same phase. There is a phase shift given by e to the power of j n theta b, and one will have minus theta b and another will have plus theta b because of directions. Okay. So, you can write the same thing. ZS you can write, this will become minus theta c, okay, this will be plus theta c, and ZBA will become, what will be ZBA? It is almost like a transpose of, because they are complex numbers. So, this will be, do not you think this will be Z A B transpose, is not it? So, that is the wind voltage induced in the other way around. Okay. K B times this into e to the power of, if you have minus theta B, it will become plus theta B, like this. Okay. And Z C A will be whatever Z A C, whatever happens, but if it is minus theta C, it will become plus theta C. Is it clear? Okay. So, we can write the impedances, all these impedances. So, you can write down the whole impedance matrix, is not it? So you can write ZBB, ZBC, ZCB, ZCC. Similarly, okay, because ZBC will be product of KB, KC, right. So this way and the nth harmony we can write this. So I suggest you try to introspect these impedances before we try to take it further. Is it clear? So we write the impedance, these are called rotating field, general rotating field impedances. Okay. So we will stop it here and take it further next class. Okay.